Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to English language class. And I am your English teacher, M.S. Yadav. You are watching YouTube channel Principal Sir, where you get learning of English language with practical and minimalist approach. So, today we'll be looking at report writing, and that can be useful for all students including class 9 to 12. And we will be taking some examples. So before going into the examples, let us go and understand some main points of report writing so that you will develop a base for writing a good report. So let us move to our lecture. As it is visible on the screen, what we are going to discuss today, how to write a report. This is the main question. How to write a report. Okay. Then, it is useful for class 10, 11 and 12. And what type of reports can be there? What should be the format, or you can say the structure of a report? And in the last, we will discuss some examples which are useful for you for the examination purpose, especially for the students. And in future also, maybe you are supposed to write some reports. So before going into the main concepts of report writing, you can see the example so that you can make out that whether this example is suitable or whether it example suits the structure, suits the type, and how it is being written. So, report on Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav 2023, which we celebrated in our school. So, this should be the title. Okay, in the beginning, it is titled. That we are going to discuss in the coming slides. And by whom it has been written? It has been written by Neha, and she reads in class 12. So this is starting, beginning point. Now on the left side of your answer sheet or your A4 size paper, you write down the city from where you are writing. Then date on which the incident happened or which you are reporting. So, in the beginning paragraph, as it is mentioned, which we will discuss later on in detail, celebrated 75th Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav with patriotic fervor. Tricolor flags adorn the school entrance, held by primary school children. Class 12 students created a tricolor rangoli, embodying the theme Nation First. This is important because this is the theme of this 75th Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. And the second paragraph will comprise, you can say, it started at 9 a.m. It was step by step we are writing. Just look at the example. In the beginning, what happened? Then, in the second paragraph, or you can say main paragraph or body of the letter, what time it started, how it started, who was the chief guest, and what children performed on the stage. And in the last paragraph, you have to write somewhere 120 to 150 words in report writing in your examination. This will be enough for you. And in the last paragraph, who distributed the prizes. What happened then? They might be have some lunch or tea party with students, and who distributed the prize distribution for students who came first and second. So let us move to the second slide. This is the then how to write reports. How to write a report. Step by step guide. So learn these steps before writing or start writing a good report for your examination purpose, so that you may get 5 marks in the examination. You will have to follow these 10 points. First, understand the purpose of the report. For what you are writing the report? What is there in the question? What the examiner wants from you to write? So the topic will be there in your question itself. So try to read the question paper properly. Then, after that, what you have to do? You have to plan. You have to plan the outlines. It means you have to plan the outlines in your mind, or you can write down on left side of your answer sheet. It means that what you are going to write, you have to plan that thing. That is very important. Otherwise, before planning, once you start writing, you might make some mistake. So always make a plan on the right side of your answer sheet, the rough side. Then begin your report. Begin your report. Report with the title, as we will see later on also, and in the beginning also I told you, the first it should be the title. Then who has written it? Who has written it? You will find it in the question paper. Then introduce the report. Introduction means about what you are writing. Then main body of the report. It should have 1, 2, and 3 paragraphs. First paragraph will be introduction. Second paragraph will contain, you can see, details of the incident or event or function, and third paragraph will contain conclusion, how the things happened to us. So you have to write all these things. Use clear language. Language is also important. That it should be clear. Means you can communicate. It should be communicate. You can communicate the main points, or it should clearly shows that the purpose of writing a report is fulfilled. Doesn't mean that you may start writing anything which has not come in your examination. So you have to see what the writer wants you to write. So just check the title and the main function. Then analyze and discussion. Analyze whether you have any discussion point. And then conclusion. Once you finish the report writing in your examination, always in the last, every children will do proofread. Reading to check grammar and spellings. and correct if you made any mistakes. So this is how you can begin writing a report by keeping in mind all these points. Let us take next slide. Now, what is, you can say, before going into details about types of reports, you must also understand what is a report. What is a report? Report is factual description of any event or accident or incident or function or data. Some report can have data, some report can have discussion, some reports can have image. So what is required, just check in your if this is how the report starts. So let us check the type of reports which you may face in the examination. The first one is, you can say, academic reports. Academic reports like annual function, school annual report, or quiz competition, sports. These all reports are called academic reports. So this is how this academic report. Then comprehension of the subject matter. You must understand the details. What is the subject matter? You must understand, such as annual day report, cultural events, charity days, charity club, sports, historical events, trips, biographies. These are all comes under the category academic reports. Then some business reports. If you are working in some MNCs or some international companies, you have to write business reports. So, what is happening in your company during the whole year? And suppose if you are manager, you have to report annual activities during the years. In the last, you have to report whether the company is going in profit or loss, or what we have adopted new things and what we are going to adopt new things in future. These are all called business reports. Then scientific reports. If someone researches, then you will have to produce, like in corona time, all data was analyzed to reach on something. So this type of reports can be, you can say, scientific. Some reports are formal. It means you will have to follow some steps or structure. You will have to follow the structure of report. So in formal report, you will have to adopt the proper structure. You cannot violate the rules. The rule of formal report. Then informal report. Sometimes you can report to your friend or some officials. Sometimes it is not annual report. You can adopt in formal way also for reporting. So this is how you can understand what types of reports should be there and how we can write the report. Now, what is the format? This is the most important thing of any report. Means, first, write down the date. Then, by whom? Report is written. Title, check in your question paper. Just check your question paper. Where you will get option between article and report writing. Article yesterday we discussed in details, and it depends upon your attitudes, your interest, that which type of things you are going to write, whether you are interested in explaining the things in detail like writing an article. And if you have taste of a reporter, then you will go for a straightforward report writing. Then introduction. Introduction of the report is also important. Then comes the main body. Main body. That we will see in the examples very soon. Main body of the report. Present information logically. It means whatever you are writing, it should be logically. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, beginning, next step, next what happened then. Suppose you prepare tea. If let us see, take one small example. You want to prepare tea. It doesn't mean you will put milk in the beginning. You will have to follow the facts. First, take some water and add, you can say, tea powder. Boil, put any herbals, then milk, boil some time and serve. It doesn't mean that you will start from here. It means you have to start from here. 1, 2, 3. It means whatever happened in the beginning, that is most important point, boys and girls, that whatever happened in the beginning, you have to write in the beginning. Whatever had happened in the last, you have to write in the last. So we will discuss it when the example will come in front of you. Visuals. If some visuals are required, some photographs, suppose you are a reporter of any newspaper, so then you will require some visuals, means some images, images, photos. So such type of reports required some images. Then conclusion, summarize key points, key findings. Means, suppose an accident happened. Explain the accident step by step. And what were the key points, main points of accident that you have to discuss. Then recommendation, some reports you have to give recommendation for students, it is not required. So provide clear and well-supported recommendation. So this is how you can write report. By you can say let us take some other important point. So now, I expect that, I hope that, and I love to see that you have understood the format of relevance. It's very easy, my dear boys and girls, my dear students. It's very easy. Just fulfill the formalities of writing the format. Follow the rule of the format of the word. And just read the question paper properly. Everything you'll get in question paper, you will get even, you can see clues also, which I will explain you. Now we will discuss some important points. One must understand, one must note down before writing a report. And what are these? Explain an event or situation. Any? Explain whatever has happened in true way. No superficial, no lies. No lies. You cannot lie. No lies. Facts only. Only facts. Right? Long-term results of an event or situation. Analytical or statistical data evaluation. Suppose you are writing report on some data. So analyze the data properly so that a decision can be reached. Interpretation based on report data. Then interpret what is data showing. So then summarize. Then make analysis of the data and reach to the conclusion. So in data reports you can write that. Prediction or recommendation based on report information. So you can predict, you can make some imagination also, or you can think or it. What information has to do with other events? Relate the events. Events one by one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, ending of events. So you will have to relate events. First beginning event should be attached to the second event. Second event attached third event. Third event should be attached to the closing maybe of the report. So the system should, suppose the function started at 9 o'clock. Suppose the function started at 9 a.m. and ended at 2 p.m. So whatever has happened between this time, explain each and everything step by step as it happened. If something doesn't happen, don't write. So this is the most important point. I'll tell you, this is going to be the most important point. No personal opinion or arguments. You are not supposed to be a reporter. Reporter cannot analyze the thing according to his or her views. It means no personal opinions allowed. And argue. Always avoid these two things. This, then report will be fine. Good. So don't put your own views on the incident, accident, situation, event, or any function. Whatever has happened, this is called factual description of the things happened in function. Things happen in an accident. Things happen anywhere. So you have to report about the facts only. No imagination, no personal opinion, no arguments with anybody. Whatever has happened, explain it clearly on the basis of data, on the basis of facts, Otherwise, the things will be difficult. Avoid modals like should, may, might. These are, you can say, it might not happen any accident if the driver of bus would have turned right. Or it may have happened the accident because of the car driver was driving the wrong way. No. Don't put these models, these auxiliaries are supposed to be avoided. Never use these auxiliaries. Okay. Only facts. Reports should be organized as per the incident that occurred. No going left, no going right, no going up, no going down. Whatever has happened, explain in system. This is the way of writing. Step by step, or beginning of incident to end, without any alteration of facts. You cannot alter any facts. You cannot change any facts. Generally, past tense is used. Suppose something happened on 15th March, or maybe yesterday, on, you can say, on 18th December, 18th. You will write on 19th. Means, you are reporting about the matter which happened yesterday, or maybe 2 hours back, maybe 2 days back. So, we generally use past tense. This is most important. Children must note it. In every sentence you will find in the reports, in the coming examples, we will be using past tense. Why? Because we always report things of the past. So, let us take some examples. Now the time has come. I will take some simple examples in the beginning. So, the example, students of class 10th and 11th will get such type of report. Report on annual sports day of PB Bose Public School. Function, annual sports. School name, PB Bose. By, who is reporting? You may be Radha. You may be Rajesh. Sports captain. You have to write a report for your school magazines about your sports day in PB Bose Public School. So, November 1st, 2023, Jhajjar, Haryana, right? On November 1st, 2023, the PB Public School hosted its annual function, Sports Day Meet, in honor of Haryana Day. First day, November is Haryana Day, in the school playground. So, location is given. Where the sports meet? School ground. The sports meet started at 10 a.m. with the speech of the Deputy Commissioner, Jhajjar, Sri Shakti Singh, who was the chief guest, spoke to the gathering about importance of games in our life. So, sports meet started with the speech of Honorable Deputy Commissioner Jhajjar Sri Shakti Singh, Captain Shakti Singh. Then, in second paragraph, in the middle part of the report, all the participating team of our houses march past, then march past started with flags of their houses and were cheered by the students and audience gathered on the ground. The annual sports day function began with athletics, different of wings of the school. Then four houses participated in kho-kho, kabaddi, badminton. And in the last paragraph, the judges made their decision on the champion house. Subhash House was champion and was declared overall winner of annual sports day. In the end, the award ceremony began and Deputy Commissioner handed over the trophy to the captain of Subhash House. Thus, the annual sports day came to an end at 6 p.m. Right? Note down the time. The function started at 10 a.m. and finished at 6 p.m. It means between 10 and 6 p.m. you have to explain the things in 120 to 150 words. Just always keep in the mind about the word limit also. And it will carry 5 marks. So this is how, and closing speech by Principal Dr. Prabhu Arya. So this is how a function, or you can say sports meets, came to an end. And this is how we must write a good report. Then, next thing, let us take one more example. Examples of report based on clues. Suppose the class 12 students, in class 12, students get clues. Just after the question, let us see how clues, hints, cues, or some important words. You are Sandhya Sohan. Who has to report? Either Sandhya or Sohan. Girls can write Sandhya, boys can write Sohan. You cannot use any other name because it is given in the question. An active member of the Animal Lovers Club. They are active member of the Animal Lovers Club. Just put attention on this, the name, which works for the welfare of animals by preventing cruelty to them. Recently you visited Mahatma Gandhi Animal Care Home. You are pleasantly surprised to see the good treatment given to the animals. Write a report in about 150 or 100, 200, or you can say 120 to 150. The word limit is reduced now. You have to follow these points. These are given hints. In CBSE, you will get class 12 students will get hints. Develop your report on the basis of these hints. Follow these hints. This is the most important thing, and this makes easy for you to write. You will feel comfortable. Injured dogs, cats, abandoned pets, very old animals, all very well cared for, well equipped medical room, veterinary, surgeon, green, surrounding, CBSE. I am not going to solve this question. Just I am looking at these phrases. Injured dogs. Dogs were there. They were injured. There were dogs and cats, and most of them were injured. So you can explain the thing like this. And some abandoned pets were also there. There were many old animals. All then, this was the situation, physically present animals and birds in that area, all very well cared. And how they were, now you are explaining the things clearly, that how they are looked after, very well cared, well equipped medical facilities, veterinary surgeon, doctor was also there, green surrounding was also green. This question has come in 2018 in Saturday. So these hints will help you to write a good report. So let us read it first. Report on Mahatma Gandhi Animal Care Home. You visited Mahatma Gandhi Animal Care Home. Write the name which is being mentioned in the question. Don't change the name. If it is not given, write yourself. I saw a proud member of Animal Lovers Club. Recently visited Mahatma Gandhi air, home, daily, you are this is the introduction. Means you are giving the facts that you wrote and opposed. It's Mahatma Gandhi, animal care home on Mars. As mentioned the day, my initial skepticism about treatment of animal in an animal themed park was proven wrong. I used to think that animals and birds are not taken care in such homes. So I was wrong. He accepted. I witnessed the compensate, you can say the love and treatment by the staff. Contrary common perception of such parks as mere attraction for profit, Mahatma Gandhi care home stood this way. You can write down middle section, explain the things on the basis of hints. Use hints. So write down the hints. Then in the last paragraph, you can write down the protection from human interference implying with house species like parrots, peacock, deer, rabbits, monkey. Mahatma Gandhi Animal Care Home offers a unique experience, urging everyone to visit. So this is conclusion. He is asking everyone, go and visit park. Then you will realize that how animals and birds are being taken care in that area. So this in this question, the things are explained clearly. Now, one more example, report on Constitution Day. One I have discussed in the beginning. Constitution Day means days, important days. Student must keep this thing in mind. This is Constitution Day, November 26. Every year we celebrate Constitution Day on November 26. So days are important to understand report writing. As I discussed the first page about, you can say, Independence Day, or you can say Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. These are burning topics. These are current affairs topic. Or a few days back, we had some elections in 4-5 states in India. So democracy or election scene, report on election scene, on election scene. This we will discuss in the next lecture, when we will discuss about the celebrations of national and international days. So this is how you can discuss about Constitution Days. So next thing, let us take report writing main points. Now what we have discussed, main points. First, what is it? Second, types of reports. Third, format of report. Fourth, you can say important points. It should be in past tense. No, may, might, should, personal opinion. These are important points. Then we took some examples. Examples from previous years, questions paper of class 12, CBSE or HBSE. So we have taken some examples. And we have taken examples from simple to difficult way with hints. Examples with hints. So this is how we have discussed all the points. And one more thing, Still, if you have any doubt, you can visit readlearnexcel.com, where you will get all reports, all questions solved, last 10 year questions paper solved, and all reports, all article writing, all notices, all reading comprehensions, everything you will get on the website. You can visit website also. So this way we have discussed everything. So boys and girls, you might have understood how to write a book, and I feel and may you may be a good reporter one day if you follow all these steps. So see you next time, boys and girls. Bye bye.